everything we see here on Earth, or in the vastness of space, is composed of tiny particles bound to one another to form atoms. Let's draw their basic structure, learn about how elements are formed, and discover their mysterious energy. Designing new elements is literally nuclear fusion, a transmutation process normally limited to particle accelerators and the bellies of stars. But before we get started designing, this is not what an atom really looks like. And not all atoms look the same. Atoms are classified into different types called elements, and look more like this. But to more easily understand an atom's structure, today let's draw using the planetary model, starting here with the core. The core is made up of particles called protons and neutrons, which all draw stuck together here in the middle. Neutrons have more mass than the protons, so I'll draw the neutrons as bigger particles. Of course, this drawing is not exactly to scale, but it's more representative of the basic structure. More on that later. Now, we can keep adding a bunch of protons and neutrons to the core, but check this out. The amount of protons and neutrons in the atom's core determines what element you're drawing. For example, you might start off drawing some simple oxygen, then you smash together a few more particles and fusion. Your element is now iron. Add even more, and you get gold or Einsteinium. Be creative and have fun designing your element. I'll draw oxygen with 8 protons and 8 neutrons to form the core. But that's not all. I think the coolest part of an element are the electrons. Electrons are particles that surround the atom's core in smooth electromagnetic wave clouds. Oxygen also has 8 electrons. And again, because we're using the planetary model, I'll choose to draw the electrons orbiting symmetrically within that wave cloud to form energy shells. Electrons I'll draw here even smaller than protons, because they have even less mass than the other particles. In reality, electrons don't really exist in any one location. The electron cloud itself just represents the probability of where the electron could be, and only takes a position once it's observed. Pretty weird stuff, huh? And if that's not mind-blowing enough, remember when I told you this drawing's not exactly to scale? Of course, this drawing's not exactly to scale, but it's more representative of the basic structure. In order for us to draw this atom to scale, these tiny particles will have to be much, much farther apart. Try this. Imagine the atom's core, all the protons and neutrons in your element, were the size of a basketball. Then the electrons would be smaller than the tip of your pencil, orbiting over 4 miles away. That would require a very large piece of paper. Subscribe to Creative Cricket for more cool art videos like this. If you like this video and want to support this channel, hit that like button and share it with all your fellow creative thinkers out there. Tell me what you'd like to draw next in the comments. And be sure to check out our other smart art lessons, perfect for growing your brain and practicing your drawing skills. Thanks for watching.